Welcome everybody, Judy here. Hope everyone is well. If you haven't been to my channel before, welcome, thank you. And I hope you enjoy the what I'm gonna show you. Okay, so Izink ice translucent gels is what I'm going to use today. And I'm just going to show you a couple of different ways of using them to create, well, you can create stained glass window with the foil behind. You don't need to use foil. I really enjoy using the foil because it just makes some beautiful pieces. Now, if I use paint on these, on foil, I actually put gesso down and before I put the paint on because it adheres and stays for longer. But these particular translucent gels don't seem to actually need it. And I haven't, this is actually just a piece of foil that's lying about. I have had pieces of foil that I've created just for playing and scrunched it up after I've put the gel on. So in saying that, you can do it either either way, I suppose. Completely up to you. Yeah, I don't even think that's clean. That's excellent. It's always good to have tools that actually aren't clean in your that little one, small one might be better. Okay, palette knife and some form of a stencil that you want to make. Okay, whether it be, as you know, I'm doing the door series, so the door art journal. So I kind of want to make a few bits and pieces to use in that journal. Unfortunately, yes, my thing is, maybe I might do this one actually. That might be better for you guys. Anyway, now I've got a few different ones now. So this is Maroon. But maron, it's French, clearly. Beige must be a French word. So shows how little I'm educated in that way. And this is black. I know that is black because it's, yeah, noir. Okay. I do wish they had Australian English labels, but anyway, doesn't matter. I am going to make these leafy sort of patterns, and obviously they should be a green colour, but I want to make them in a brown, a browny tinge actually, and maybe the ice white, which is very, very beautiful actually. I'm going to put that on there. It's like a pearl. I would call it a pearl. Nacre. I don't know what that is. Wish I did. If I have time, I will learn. Alright, I'm going to put both of them onto the palette knife. And I'm just going to slide them. Oops. Mind if the stencil doesn't get filled up, but normally when I'm doing this I try and make enough for a door or enough of, you know, when I'm designing something, enough for a particular picture to have enough of it in. Enough of the pieces, because you don't want to go back and start making it again. Especially, I can't. I always forget what colours I used, and I don't know whether you're the same. Most of the time. So I just spread that all out. Oh. Fill in all the little gaps. Work with it a long time, it's very open. I think I bug it up, but you know, you will take more care, I'm sure. Won't you? Yes. And then I just got this little piece of so I'm going to take that off now. I'm just going to put that on there like so, and I might just get oh, I can just use that. That's this piece of rice paper kicking about, that's fine. Yes, I love it. Now I'm going to have to do another one, of course, because my book is about it's smaller than an A3, but it's not that much smaller. So I'll just pull all that off, and that just comes off like so, as you can see, like that. That's a very open pattern I've used too. But that will dry beautifully. We'll just, is there another piece of foil kicking around? Plain piece of foil, here we go. This one's actually been scrunched, but that doesn't matter. Be doing a I will show you my new, I've started working in it already, my new art journal with the temples, doors and windows, and I am creating actual interpretations on each page of things that I've seen that I love. I have made so many pictures in my travels to inspire me. Ooh, should take that off. It's drying instantaneously. Okay. Down again. It really? I mean, they are beautiful, beautiful colors and translucent. I use them on many things now, the translucent. They're really good for just sealing the paper too, you know, how I use the clear gesso or the coffee stained clear gesso. I use this too. This makes a lovely translucent seal over the paper. Expensive though, hey, than them off. Easier, I suppose. Just one more little bit there, I think. To work with whatever I decide to do in my art journal. Other photos of stained glass windows and rounds I've done. I haven't got any red, and I'm going to have to order it the next time I order some, but I actually haven't got any red of this gorgeous Izink ice translucent gel, and I kind of missed that, so I don't know how in my order I missed it, but I did. So just having the jelly plate underneath that little, this is the little one that I made, and yeah, with the Australian measurements, which could be easily trying any country, but yes. So I don't do a big pieces because I only need small pieces really. Just put that off there. That pearl is gorgeous. Very translucent and shimmery though. Ah, that's nice. All right. So that's the off. Gorgeous. I can use that over the top since it's on see-through paper, and that's the other one. Alright, now if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask, subscribe and like, and I will catch you on the next tutorial. Thanks heaps. Take care. Bye.